Hello and welcome to Farming Simulator 2015 with me, Kevin Sawyer. And you join me today and we're all ready for the harvest of our corn. And gonna announce the winners of the 2016 calendars. Unfortunately only sort of one person entered, so I'm gonna say it's right off the bat. If there's any misunderstanding and people wanted to enter but didn't understand how to enter, sorry guys, but unfortunately I did sort of state what you needed to do to enter. I know it wasn't a big competition anyway, but giveaway anyway, but because no one else, sort of like only one person said the right things, I wasn't sure if you guys wanted to enter or whether you're just commenting generally. Anyway, I digress. So it's I'm sorry I'm gonna butcher your name right now, but it's Spartan Pilot 01, and hopefully the calendar should be winging its way to you as we speak, so or as I speak I should say. So the other ones, I'm going to keep one for myself, I've decided, and then I'll give one to the a good friend of mine, so when I see him next, they're going to get a nice little surprise. So, but anyway, I digress again. So anyway, today we're going to be doing some harvesting of corn, so we'll set these guys up. So let's bring up course play, want him to turn to right, do that. Higher. Hopefully this will work. Hopefully this will work. There we go. Right, I'm gonna get these guys off and away. Sorry, skipping through everything again. I hope everyone's okay. Up to 53 subscribers now, and big thank you to everyone again. And I hope you're all okay. I hear you shouting it back at me. Yeah, we're all good, Kev. How are you? I'm good. Very good, thank you. Just want to apologise about the sporadic amounts of uploading and lack of uploading this week. Could be work commitments and everything. Set this guy up to the right, higher. So, as respect to ATS, some of you guys might be thinking, well, where's that? You said you're going to bring it on as soon as it launched. I will bring it on. I'm just going to wait a little while, purely just to see what SES have got for it, in terms to, but it is in the plans. I will bring it on shortly, just with financial commitments and everything. I just can't justify outlaying another, I know it's only 15 quid or so on Steam, but with everything else that's coming out this month, it's a just going to have to hold up and wait for it. Unfortunately I'm going to miss the boat on all the potential views, but I'm hoping you guys are going to join me in watching it anyway. I know you've probably already seen everyone else playing it. I know Sinky's playing, yeah, and he got a bit of a rage quit. That really made me laugh, by the way, Sinky, and so I'm glad you uploaded it. Brightened my day up a lot. So I was just like, that's sort of laugh I needed just to get me through the day. So this is field 32 anyway, I digress. Field 32. Actually, make sure the course, oh, I already had it reloaded. Empty Kev. Try again. Settings. Yeah, that's good to me. Drive. He's probably going to drive around to the point again, but hey ho. Or he's going to drive straight into a tree. Right, get this guy off and away. Whoops. Stop. Delete that. Temporary cost. Field. What's this? Field 33. Field 33. It should be under overloader. Hopefully, or did I inadvertently delete it? Which one is it? Okay, I may have not saved it. Right, so we'll do that quickly. I have to quickly start, of course, recording, so... Because I realised the other one wasn't quite, working. So we'll do that quickly here. And once he's set up, he's off and away. Alright, so bring out the pipe. Hopefully that's close enough. And then put in the waypoint. Drive on. Driving back into the field. Stop. I'll name that course. Hopefully it's just get him to drive it now and drive the course. So stop. There it is. Is it overloader? Yeah. Settings look about good. 65. Put that to 90. Drive course. Drive now. Hopefully today's plan in the episode, I'm gonna sort of start getting the bakery ready for the making of bread and everything. So that's another thing we're gonna be doing hopefully today, as long as everything goes right and course play behaves itself. Yeah, that looks good to me. So I'm gonna get this guy up and running. Set up and running. Right, what course are you driving? You're driving the... You're already on it. Yeah, you're already on it. So, drive course. Oh, make sure he's going on the right thing. Yep. Settings. 90%. Yep. Of course, he's gonna probably turn around on himself. If I get him to drive it now, yes, should hopefully sort himself out. Hopefully, not make me look like a lemon. It's not hard to do, I know. No, he's gonna go around in circles and make me look like a lemon. Okay, Mr. Courseplayer, you wanna play it that way? Sorry if you can hear the. Kids playing outside, it's beyond my control, unfortunately. Right, so let us go and get some flour from the windmill first, and I'll show you what's needed, well, stage one hopefully of what's needed in a flower production. Bring the wheel up. And as we're driving about, we'll take the oil off. Beacons on. So a lot of work, busy farm today. Busy workload on the farm today. I'm not going to do it all on screen. So obviously, I'll keep an eye on the time. And I'm glad everyone's enjoying the new playthrough of Belgique Performed Classic Farming episode that I sort of started on here. And I'm planning to bring up some more episodes of that. So. Keep your eyes out for that, guys. For the ones that are interested in watching that series as well as this one. And like I said in that episode, don't worry, guys. I'm not going to give up on this farm. This farm's still got a lot of work to do. And the plans for next will be, once we've done all the harvesting of this corn, I'm going to be going on to doing sugar beets and potatoes. So, and I've never tried using those machines on that, so I've tried the big harvesters on there, but I've never tried those little ones that you mount onto the back of the tractor. So, or the front of the tractor and the back of the tractor. Don't crash. Good. So that'd be a bit of a learning curve for me. So I'm looking forward to doing that. Right, let's get out the cabs, because I don't want to invert me. Pull under that. If I don't have to, that mixed ration tipper. Because that little spout is, that's mixed ration. Your flour is on this little pallet over here. Hoping I can get to it without too many dramas. Whoops, like that. As you were laughing, oh, typical Ledford Kev. Yeah. Oh, there we go. So it's loading up. So as you see, you can load up the flour. Don't know how much this is going to hold. Don't know how much this is in here. No, I didn't put a massive amount here. I put at least a trailer load in here. While that's doing that, quickly just check everyone else is okay. See, oh dear. Right, okay. Quickly jump out. Jump in him. Stop driver. He's causing massive issues here. Start driver. Hopefully, sort his life out now. Maybe not. Okay, so we need to adjust this. This is all from when. Okay, let's quickly stop him. Let's quickly adjust all this. Sorry about this, guys. Just gonna make sure vehicle offset is set to auto. These are all from the chaff run. I forgot about this. Should. Okay, auto. Auto. Right, okay, cool. Drive. So you should automatically now see the tip point, yep. Or the trailer spout, and not be set for the other tractor. Or the other tipper, hopefully. Well, then again, maybe not. So, you're all laughing. You rely on course play too much, Kev, you were saying, probably. Yep, you're not wrong. I do. It often makes a monkey out of me, on many occasions. Alright, so he should be almost set up. He's set up. This guy's probably full now, good. Alright, so this next option, next thing you need to do is you need to drive this down to your bakery. Now, wherever you placed your bakery, that is. I think you can sell it directly to these sell points here, but don't quote me on that. I know that's someone's favourite little expression. It's my little get out of jail card. Someone don't want someone saying, "Oh, you said it was going to sell it, but it doesn't." That's a typical response when you get it wrong. I'm only guessing. I've not actually tried it myself. I think I may. Well, I'll say I haven't tried it, but I might have tried it at one point. But forgotten how, or when, what was the outcome of that? So anyway, I digress yet again. You tip your flour in here. It should start filling up with flour. Then, next thing you need, you're gonna need some cucumber. Now I think I've got a little bit of cucumber. Beacons on, Kev. up in the main farm here, so we'll go and have a look at that. So that should start making bread, at least anyway. Drive this bad boy back up to the main farm. Now things are, I was thinking, sort of like, with aspects to the, what I do with the channel. Now, well, like I was mentioning earlier with sporadic, uploads. Now guys, something I might say to you guys, would you prefer me doing it on a scheduled sort of upload basis, or would you prefer the way I'm doing it at the moment? Say if I were to make up some, obviously I've got to try and, like I said, but I may have said in previous episodes, I've got to try and schedule it round work and everything. I think this is cucumber here. Tomatoes, pears, apples, no. Carrot, onions, kohlrabi, lettuce, olive, grapes. Where is that then? I'm sure it's cucumber back here. I'm sure that's cucumber. We've not got any. Tomato, oh yeah, cucumber. Right, okay. Better park this out of the way. Doesn't stop. Oops. Stop the trailers getting in the way of anyone else doing their work. So. So where is the cucumber? It's that over here, isn't it? I'm sure it's the second one in. No, is that carrots? No, it's cucumber. Cool. I'm not sure it's got tomato as well, so I'm going to need some of them. Is tomato in this? Yeah, tomato's also in this as well. So we'll find out what's, while that's loading up, I'm going to quickly look, see what side tomatoes are. They look like tomatoes to me. Alright, okay. Again guys, if you're new to the channel and wondering what this mod's all about, I have covered it once or twice before in my previous episodes of Volksholm here, so please feel free to go back through my videos. And I forget what episode it was, I think it was the Ross episode where I'm harvesting the greenhouses perhaps. Again, don't quote me on that. Where I put the mod links for these guys in. But if you don't want to go through all that hassle, I know you guys have got a lot of, you know, don't have a lot of time on your hands, so you've got a lot of things to do. If you go onto like Mod Holsters or whoever and look for Ross, Ross and Fowler mods, you should bring up a whole lot of them. As long as he's a mod are there, I'm sure you have some sort of links towards something he's done on there, or maybe. I'm pretty sure he's definitely on there. On Mod Holsters. I don't know what other. I think he might be with Maru, but again, don't quote me on it. Where's that other trailer gone over there? Okay. So now we've got tomatoes and cucumbers. Now I've got to remember how to reverse. Get myself ready for the ATS, I should say. I'm a bit disappointed. I really wanted to play it, especially as it came out earlier. I was going to, you know, do a video recording and more or less upload it straight away, but life got in the way, unfortunately, so that is the downside of life. It tends to ruin your plans where it can. It bites you in the bum quite often. Anyway, I digress yet again. I'm gonna apologise for all the driving back and forth, but this is the grind of the farm, unfortunately. I wonder if those tractors are finished. I'll have to go and once we get down there and start unloading that, we'll go back over to we'll go back over to them and check them out, make sure they're okay, move them around if needs be. Yeah, so, may have not covered it all in chat initially, but with, again, going back to the, would you guys want me to do it, structure it on a calendar sort of like situation, so, say, do farming simulator on Sunday, Monday, this is just, again, just ideas running through my head, do ARC and whatever on a Tuesday, ATS on a Wednesday, or... You know, with all the games I'm covering, well, actually, if you guys, is there something you guys are interested in me trying to do again? I need to go around the back, don't I? Again, please comment down below. You know, so yeah, it sounds like a good idea, Kev. So then we know when to come in to watch whatever, rather than just seeing a video being uploaded by me and then go right, well. I don't watch Farming Simulator, or I don't watch ARC, or I don't watch Long Dark, or that's all. Cool. Cool beans. Again, guys, like I said, I'm kind of trying to work it round work and everything else until I either win the lottery or this generates enough views to sort of like pay its way. And I can sort of like think about giving up working in the retail, and but that's probably a long way off anyway. Oh yeah, dreamland, Kev, dreamland. Anyway, so once everything's filled up, the flour's only at 12%, so we're not going to get a great deal out of this. But as you can see, once it's all filled up to 100%, it should start producing sandwiches at some point. So it produces bread and sandwiches, which you can sell in your shops. So I'll leave this little track just down here quickly, because again, I can go off screen and take that back to the. Well, these guys are going good. Get rid of that. There's only a problem with using auto combine. It kind of works a bit like. He's going well. How's the other guy doing? He's finished. Right, okay. So get rid of that. So we need to now bring him down to the other field. There's a fairly small field anyway, so... A fairly small field, I should say. But I'm definitely looking forward to... ATS, something I will say, Moose, been watching Moose's footage of it. Now, he goes on about floating gears. Now, floating gears, for you guys that aren't aware what floating gears are, it's where you, it's clutchless gear shifting, pretty much. Now, there's a big school of debate on whether that's a good thing to do or a bad thing to do. Some experts or some drivers, truck drivers or car drivers, said it does no harm to the gearbox as long as you do it right and you don't ram it in. So basically what you what you do is clutchless. So rather than using your clutch, if you're a manual driver, rather than automatic, rather than using the clutch to shift the gears, you roll off the accelerator, and it's all dependent on RPM, torque factor and everything of the engine, and it is quite an art to do, so it's something, you know, not for a novice driver to take up on, not straight away, once you've had a few years of experience of driving clutchless or floating gears, then only gearbox can take it. That's definitely something you need to take into Victor. Yeah, basically what you do is you take it out of gear, roll off the accelerator, take it out of gear, then bring it into the next gear, but don't, and then what you do is with your gear selected, kind of hover in the gate, if you know what I mean. So what you do is, say you go from third to fourth or whatever, so you take it out of third, and then move it gently into fourth, but don't force it in. What you feel, you should feel it if you've got a good sense of what your gearbox is doing. You should feel it where the gears, where it's trying to mesh, and should as you again, as you roll it in, as you're rolling off the accelerator and rolling it in, you should feel it sort of like go in a sense, it's slotting in a sense, that's what I'm trying to get at. So don't force it in. If you try to push it in and hear it grind out, then yeah, back off and then come back to it. Well, I'll get this guy off anyway. So 5 higher. I've got to turn his turning circle yet higher. And off he goes. It should be on his way, merry little way now. Where's that other guy? You're right. Stop, driver. Yeah, so that's basically the prime principle of clutchless or floating of the gears. You can do it. It is a form of art of changing. It's not for everyone. And a lot of the old, like, crash box gearboxes, it's more difficult still, because I'd say maybe, I'd say probably would be a bit more difficult on the crash gearboxes, because they can tend to be tetchy at the best of times anyway. Anyway, it's telling me it needs to be unloaded, so just quickly get this guy off and away. So which field is this? This is field 25. Unload field 25. I'll just drive him into the field. Excuse me. I'm hoping he doesn't make a ham sandwich out of it and drives. Yeah. Stop. Where are you going? Should be here. Make sure I've got field 25 loaded. This is field 25, isn't it? Double check. Field 25. Yeah, unload field 25. Drive course. There he goes. Good, he's picked that up. He should dump off what he's got anyway. Okay, he must have unloaded. Cool. Cool beans, he's full. He needs emptying. Let's request the old driver. And here he comes. I think he is waiting till the other guy comes to the end of his path, but he ran out of a option there. He's almost good to go. They've almost finished that. We've got a couple of runs there. Yeah, so Anyway, I digress it again. I can't understand how Moose does it. Because, okay, I believe he uses a G27 steering wheel. Don't quote me on that, but I believe he uses a G27 steering wheel. And obviously, with the gear selection on that, it's not really attached to a proper box. So, it's just in the gate or out the gate. So I can't understand, unless he's doing it by ear, how he's doing it, because he wouldn't be able to feel the gear box in any way or shape or form, unless he's just making a note of what the rev limit is and where he needs to do it and remembering where to shift, if he is doing it that way. I'm not going to say he's not doing it, because that would be the nasty thing to say. I'm sure he is doing it as he says to it. I just want to understand how he's doing it. Because if you can't feel the box, how are you going to do a clutchless shift? So that's one what made me wonder when I was watching his live stream the other day, with if he's double D in his clutch or not. Because that's what I'd do if I can't feel it. I'd just push down on the clutch halfway down and just make sure that it doesn't grind the box as you're trying to push it in. But anyway, I digress yet again. We're almost done on this field. Sorry, we've missed a little bit there, so I'll come back and do that off screen. We must be getting up to near enough the halfway mark, hour mark now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please don't forget to like. And if you're new to my channel and you're here for the first time, hello and welcome. And you want to see more videos of this or anything else I'm working on, please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. TTFN.